All right, now we go on to the next match, and Tony Schimmel does something that I got to do at Nox Pro, and that's introduce Ricardo Rodriguez. That's Albert Del Rio's personal ring announcer, and I just want to let you guys know Albert Del Rio is actually, according to my sources, Dos Caras Jr.,
right.
The nephew of Mil Mascaras, the man of a thousand holes, the man of a thousand masks, and he's not wrestling with his mask on, and it's a very big deal. This guy's very talented. What happened here? Give me the story.
Well, for one thing, I didn't think I'd ever see Chris Masters back in WWE.
Can you believe it?
No. But I thought this was the match of the night. But it shows me that submission holds will beat out power moves any day of the week.
Did you notice that?
Oh, yes. You know, and backing up here, I don't know who this Ricardo Rodriguez guy is, but he's one of the best ring announcers in the WWE.
I agree.
All he's missing is a white fedora.
I have no idea what that means because I'm Hebrew Heat, right?
Oh, yeah. I
can you see me winking? Wink.
Anyway,
it was an absolute honor to introduce Ricardo Rodriguez twice at Nox Pro for K. Ross Covington. And I know if he was here, he'd really, you know, like that. Jackhammer by Masters, an old Goldberg move to start it off.
Right.
Del Rio gets after the arm, weakening the option of the Master Lock. I really like that. Masters, a Samoan drop and a power slam. Cross arm breaker applied after an arm bar, code breaker, tappy. That is one phenomenal submission going back to what you said. Dos Caras looking phenomenal.
That was beautiful. You know, what really caught my eye though was at the very end after he won the match and he's outside the ring and he walks up to Big Show and Big Show puts his hand out to shake his hand. He looks at him, looks like he's going to shake his hand, and just gives us a shot, this coy little wink, you know, like,
that was great.
Then he walked away, and the cool thing is, Big Show was cool with it. He respected that.
Yeah, he said, well, you know what, the guy, you know, he made it interesting. Plus, I mean, of course, this guy's pedigree, or luchability, as you would say.
Right.
There's not many higher. I mean, you have to go to El Hijo de Santo, or Rey Mysterio Sr. himself. Albert Del Rio, very, 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 very happy. All the time.
Oh, yeah.
Comes in a little a la Eddie Guerrero in a car, you know, when he entered. And, of course, Ricardo Rodriguez very happy because his guy won. And now he's part of Team SmackDown. Even his picture looks good. I don't know if you noticed that.
Alberto's just oozing confidence. It's amazing.
And talent and everything. This guy's got a huge future.
Oh, it's tremendous.
Okay, Edge arrives in his gear and hits the ring, and he's ready to wrestle.
You know?
Promo match. I mean, it's great. And he's fighting the Intercontinental Champion, Dolph Ziggler.
You know, Dolph Ziggler, if he grew his hair a little longer, he looked just like the Mr. Perfect. Well, in fact, you know, this was the match of the night as far as I'm concerned. But you got to remember that in wrestling, everything old is new again. And this match had the same intensity and brutality as a feud that I witnessed in the mid-80s with Larry Zbysko and Nick Bockwinkel.
Huh.
Yeah, Larry Zbysko, he would use anything and everything to try to cripple Nick.
Huh.
It didn't matter if he won or lost. As long as he could end Nick Bockwinkel's career. And that's the same type of intensity and fortitude I saw in this match.
Wow. Very good. You know what I saw? I saw Vicky and Caitlin watching on, and in the back on a monitor, but Caitlin's butt. I mean, Jennifer Lopez must be jealous of this. This girl is gorgeous. It's going to be nice to see her. Let's see. Edge baseball slide. Ziggler goes for a tornado DDT, and Edge reverses into a straight thrust kick. You remember that in the corner where he just lifted up his leg?
Yeah, and boy, that was a good job.
He did a phenomenal job. Dolph flips to the floor. There's a failed spear and a zigzag into the stairs. That's called the zigzag when he jumped up.
Oh, right.
Looks kind of like a Shelton Benjamin pay dirt.
Maybe put him into the steps.
That was brutal. That's called a zigzag.
That was brutal.
Okay, Edge doing some high flying. A neck breaker pin combo that we always see, you know, when he grabs the back of the neck and just pulls down.
Right.
Reminiscent of the Vampire Warrior, a spike. Like DDT, you know, a little Gangrel move there, a failed spear, and his opponent goes to the top, and Edge spears this guy from the jump off the top rope. You know this is over. One, two, three, and Edge is part of Team Bragging Rights and Team SmackDown. Taker's still waiting.
He's waiting?
Yeah, he's still waiting.
Yeah.
Outside.
Right.
Up on the top.
Up on the top.
Still waiting.
Right, still waiting.
Okay.
Very patient.
Show versus Caval, all show. All the time, all day.
Yeah, it sounds simple enough. Caval just has the last 5 minutes in the ring to make Team SmackDown.
Yeah, without a concussion.
Right. Now,
now before you get into that, I just want to let you know there were a lot of low-key chants.
Right.
A lot.
In fact, this Caval, that reminds me, this Caval looks a lot like a guy who used to wrestle in Florida a few years ago.
It is.
But, you know,
Kavala, leg bigger.
But Kavala, or I should say Loki, he should be wrestling Amazing Red or one of the Flying Elvises. It shouldn't be the Big Show or anything.
Well, I got to be honest with you, man. Amazing Red is not getting as much. I mean, you don't see him that much anymore. Because, mm-hmm. I don't know, maybe he lacks psychology. But the fact is that Kaval is finally going to get a chance to show off what he knows. And it's going to be interesting to see because he did go for the Warrior's way at the end.
But Tyler Rex, what's up with him, dude?
Oh, my God.
I didn't even recognize him.
This is Tyler Rex times two.
2.0.
He's huge. This is the Tyler Rex that came in on ECW.
Right.
Same guy.
He's puny.
But he's three times as... Oh.
Well, he must have ate his Wheaties, dude.
Well, Kaval versus Rex and a failed Warrior's Way, a fireman's carry, and a popover DDT. 1, 2, 3. Kind of like an attitude adjustment with a DDT. Kind of interesting. But Kaval gets his spot, and that's the end of it.
Yep. Just when you thought it was safe.
Tashing Cody and the nails. I actually learned how to do my nails. I'm still going to bite them.
You like the
emery, but I still learned.
Do you like the emery board thing or
the nail polish
the
thing?
The nail polish thing, yeah. Right.
You know why? Because I've actually had a lot of wrestlers come up to, a lot of wrestlers have come up to K. Ross Covington and told him that they use that because your nails will split on the mat. So these guys do a lot of stuff. You're right, nail polish is not just
I never
for
knew
girls.
How to shape a nail before. Now I know.
Yeah, well. Let's see if it comes in handy.
Right, great.
Drew McIntyre versus Kofi. Huge kick from the corner. Drew he's the most aggressive star in the WWE? Really?
Well,
that's his tagline?
You're with the carry me on this one because I watched this match and nothing came to me. I have nothing
on I'll tell you what came to me, that trouble in paradise at the end.
Okay.
Wow. Right. He hit him dead on. Mm-hmm. I was really impressed. 1, 2, 3, and Kofi is a member.
That's right.
All right, so...
Last but not least... Taker beats up on Kane. Whoopee.
Yeah, seen it.
I'm
you know, I like Taker, I understand, but I also understand why he's there. He's a name, you know, and Kane is the champion, and I really like that because now the question is, will Kane become the new Undertaker? Your thoughts?
Well, the great thing about Kane is that, you know, the scriptwriter's really good at break when he comes out.
Oh, yeah,
he doesn't say anything.
So. Well, you know, he came out, he did a nice promo, he kept it to the point. He built his character, he made people scared, and he's the champion. So he's going to win. And Kane has been wrestling for, 14 years for the WWE? Mm-hmm. He definitely deserves this big push. And I would like to see Kane become the new Undertaker. I really would.
I think it's going to happen.
Well, we'll have to wait and see. So, anything else?
I think that's about it.
Let's touch one more time on Ricardo Rodriguez because it's really nice to see him in the ring, being announced by Tony Schimmel, doing his intros, doing his outros. I'm very impressed with Ricardo Rodriguez. You?
I love him.
If we could translate his entrance, for Albert Del Rio, it's like, you know, this guy is the man. No, wait a minute. He's the only man that can do this, this, this. Very good. Very good. He's looking good, too. So, Ricardo Rodriguez, big ups to you. We hope you have a very successful career. Maybe one day we'll even see you wrestle. You never know.
Excellent.
Yeah. All right. So, that'll do it. I hope you guys enjoyed the SmackDown review. That'll take care of everything. And we'll get these out intermittently. I know CJ likes to put his stuff out right away, but we'll take our time. And I just hope you guys enjoy the show. Leave your comments. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. And as always, we leave with the best tagline in the business.
King Fred out! Excuse me.